Hey mamas, is your due date right around the corner or has it already maybe come and gone and you're sitting at the computer screen with that burning question, how do I get this baby out of me? I get it, mama. By the end, you're so uncomfortable, but probably more than anything, you are just so ready to finally meet your baby. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you 10 tips to help you naturally induce labor. I'm Bridget and I'm a birth doula in the San Francisco Bay Area and I love helping moms love their birth. For more tips and tools on how to have an empowered birth, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. First of all, mamas, you can do all 10 of these tips, and if baby isn't ready, they still may not come. Baby is kind of running the show here. They are the captain of the ship, and so if they're not ready to set sail yet, then they're gonna stay in there cooking up still. With that being said, these tips have helped so many women, myself included, who, in the hopes of getting labor started, tried these tips and got what they wanted. So let's get started on these 10 tips to induce labor naturally. As with anything that you do in pregnancy, you want to make sure that you are checking in with your care provider so that they give you the green light to do all of these things before you do them. So the first tip that I have for you to naturally kickstart labor is to clear out your fears. Labor is going to progress best when you are feeling calm and relaxed, and sometimes our fears are what's holding us back from getting labor started. So when you're anxious or afraid, your body is going to hold on to a lot of tension that's going to really prevent your body from becoming soft and open to allow baby to come down and out. Not only that, but the hormones that are released from fear, anxiety, are killers of the natural labor hormone called oxytocin. So obviously, if there's fear and anxiety about birth, that's going to affect you getting into labor somehow. I go into depth about how fear creates pain in labor in this video, so make sure you check that out so you know exactly how fear plays a role in the birth space. So how exactly do you clear fear? Well, we have 9 more steps to go, and I created a whole video about this. So instead of giving it all right here, I'm gonna have you check out this video up here. I'll link it down in the descriptions below. So make sure you check that out so that you are able to eliminate your fears about childbirth and start that natural induction for labor. So the second tip that I have for you is to practice hypnobirthing. Now, before you start thinking I'm a crazy person trying to hypnotize you, I want you to know that hypnosis is a state that most people experience on a regular day-to-day basis. So you know that feeling when you're really in the groove of doing something, maybe if you're an experienced driver and you're driving and you know the roads and you've just kind of like gone into that trance mode, or maybe you're cleaning and you know all the steps that you have to do and you're just kind of in this like zone where you're relaxed but you know what your body's doing. That's a state of hypnosis. That is a state of deep relaxation, whether you know it or not. So hypnobirthing uses visualization and meditation to deepen this state of relaxation. So one of my favorite phrases is, where the brain leads, the body follows. And so in that same regard, when you are listening to a track of someone who's doing hypnobirthing, or you are listening to a, you know, live person who's speaking these affirmations to you, they are speaking these truths to your brain so that your body follows in that same direction. So basically, as your brain is letting those words and phrases and affirmations to really seep into the brain, they are going to seep in and then transform your body to be able to walk where the brain is leading it to go. You can search in YouTube several different hypnobirthing meditations. I'm going to have some pregnancy affirmation meditations coming for you, so stay tuned for those. Or you can go more in depth and take a course on it. And I will link in the descriptions a e-course on hypnobirthing that I absolutely love that you can check out for yourself on your own time. So hypnobirthing is a great way to naturally induce labor. The third tip that I have for you is exercise. Movement is one of the best ways to prepare yourself and your baby for labor. Now, I know as pregnancy progresses, it can become a lot more difficult to move your body and get out and exercise, but mama, if you are sitting on the couch all day, your baby is going to be sitting on the couch all day too. What do I mean by that? I mean that baby isn't going to be super motivated to come out if you aren't really being active and moving and kind of helping them along that process. If you are moving, baby is going to be moving too. So what are some exercises that you can do? Obviously, walking is a super great one, especially when you are so late in the game during pregnancy. It's a really easy one on your body, but it's a really good one with the way that you're moving your body to help baby come down into the pelvis to put pressure on your cervix. If you want to step it up a little bit, hiking is really good too. Swimming is fun if you just have kids that you need to be active with. Go to the park with them, play with them. Really whatever you can do to get up off the couch, get up off your bed, and be active and move your body. Tip number four is to use a birthing ball. And a birthing ball is basically a special word for an exercise ball. If you're looking for a cheap but great birth ball to get started on to help you induce your labor, then I have one. I'll link it in the descriptions below that I use, that I let my mamas that I work with use, and I absolutely love it. So check it out if you would like that one. So a birth ball is great in helping induce labor naturally because it can really help open up your pelvis and allow baby to get in an optimal position to put a nice good pressure on your cervix so that they can kickstart labor for you. Not only that, but it also is a really comfortable stretch that you can do, and it's really nice towards the end of your pregnancy, and so it just brings a lot of comfort while you are trying to induce your labor. So the first thing that you can do with a birth ball is just to lean over it with your arm so it's nice and comfortable, so your chest is on the birth ball and your belly button is facing towards the ground. So this is really going to help if baby is in a mal position where maybe their back of the head is resting on your spine, to help them turn over while your belly is kind of suspended and they have a little bit more wiggle room to twist and turn around so that their face now is facing the spine and the back of their head isn't on the spine. So that can really help put them in a good position to start your labor for you. The next tip that I have for you has a little fun way to help you remember what to do on a birth ball, and that's to rock and roll on it. So basically, when you're on the birth ball, you just kind of sway your hips, you rock them back and forth just like that, and then you can roll your hips as well so that it's kind of in this circular motion or a figure eight motion. And while you're doing that, you want your legs pointed outward so that you have the most space between your legs, and so that it's opening your pelvis for baby to be engaged in it in a optimal way. These are just a few tips on how to use a birth ball to induce labor. If you want to know more tips on how to use a birth ball during pregnancy, during labor, even into postpartum, I'm going to be making a video all about how to use a birth ball, so make sure you are tuning in for that video. So the fifth tip that I have for you is acupressure, and I have two methods to share with you to help induce labor naturally. So the first location that I want to show you is going to be between your index finger and your thumb, and it's just this nice fleshy part of your hand. If it's too far out, you're too close to like the outer part of your skin, that's not it. And if you're too far towards the center, it's going to be bony. So if you're feeling like any bone, you need to come up a little bit. So it's just this nice fleshy area. And a good tip for you to remember how to do it is to bring your thumb close to your hand, and where this little bulge of flesh is where you're going to place your finger to apply firm pressure to. The next acupressure location is right above your ankle, about four finger widths above the top of your ankle, and it's behind your shin bone. So again, if you're on the bone, then you've gone too far forward. You want to just slide your finger back a little bit so you're on that nice like fleshy area that's behind the shin bone, and four fingers up from the top of your ankle. Now, in order for acupressure to be effective in inducing labor naturally, you need to make sure that you are actually spending time doing it. So if you're just doing it once a day for a minute or so, then it's probably not going to be very effective. So for both the hand and the leg acupressure, you're going to want to do it for 2 to 3 minutes every few hours all throughout the day. And when you're applying pressure, you definitely want it to be firm enough where you can feel it, and maybe it's not like the most comfortable sensation, but you definitely don't want it to be painful. And that's how you know that you're applying enough pressure for that acupressure to actually be effective. So the sixth tip that I have for you is nipple stimulation, and you can use this to help naturally induce labor as well as during the birth process to make sure that labor progresses nicely. So let me give you a little science lesson behind using nipple stimulation to induce your labor. So when your nipples are stimulated, oxytocin is released from the pituitary gland. And oxytocin is that beautiful labor hormone that makes the cervix nice and soft and helps those uterine contractions become nice and consistent, as well as helping them build an intensity to eventually bring baby down and out. So studies show that nipple stimulation will generally work better when a woman already has a favorable cervix. So, you know, when it's softer, when you're a little bit more dilated, more effaced, that's when nipple stimulation is really going to have the best effect. You can either do it with a breast pump or you can do it manually. And if you're doing it manually, basically what you want to do is take your fingers or you can use your hand and you're going to want to rub or like roll the nipple between your fingers. You can massage or like rub around the areola, which is a darker part around your nipple. Anything that's going to feel good and that is stimulating your nipple. You want to focus on one breast at a time and you can do it for 5 minutes and then take a 5 minute break and then switch to the other side, and you can do this for about 25 or 30 minutes. I should mention here that the more that you enjoy it, the more effective that it will be. So if you enjoy having your partner be a part of it, let them join the process and help you do some stimulating. The seventh tip that I have for you is to use essential oils. And the two that I'm going to focus on in this little area is clary sage and rosemary. These two essential oils are really awesome to help induce labor, but also to use during labor to keep those contractions coming nice, steady, and strong. I've even worked with nurses during births who have little blends of their own that the hospital uses to apply to women on their acupressure spots to keep those contractions coming. But of course, with anything, you want to talk to your care provider before you start using them, either during pregnancy or during your birth. Another thing that I want to add is to make sure you are using therapeutic grade essential oils, because if they aren't pure and to the highest quality, then you aren't sure what exactly you're putting on or into your body, which can pose a risk for you and for your baby. The ones that I love using are doTERRA, Young Living, and Aracasia. So how can you use clary sage and rosemary to help kickstart labor for you naturally? Well, the first way that I have for you is to use a cloth, either flannel or cotton or some kind of material of some sort, and put a few drops of clary sage and a few drops of rosemary and just inhale that during the day, or put it under your pillow at night so that you are smelling it. Or another way to do it is just to diffuse it in a diffuser throughout the day. So if you're trying to induce labor with these essential oils, make sure you're using a good amount. Don't be stingy at this point. Make sure you're doing several drops in that diffuser, several drops on that piece of flannel cloth that you can put under your pillow so that you're actually getting it into your system enough. So another way that you can use that clary sage and that rosemary is, like I said earlier, that the nurses use, they use it on acupressure points. So you can do that on your own too by applying that clary sage and rosemary to your hand or to your ankle. Or if you are getting a massage, you know, at a professional massage place, or, you know, you're just having your partner give you a massage, either way, you can apply that topically with a carrier oil such as coconut oil. So you just do several drops of that clary sage, several drops of that rosemary with some coconut oil, slather that on your body and get a massage and hit those acupressure points, and labor may start for you. The next tip that I have for you is to use castor oil. So not a ton of research has been done on the use of castor oil to induce labor, but on the studies that they have done, women who have used castor oil to help them induce labor naturally are 58% more likely to go into labor within 24 hours after taking that castor oil than women who didn't use it. So basically, castor oil will cause your muscles in your intestines and your uterus to contract. Now, sometimes these contractions can make you feel nauseous or have diarrhea, but sometimes desperate times call for desperate measures. If you have reached that moment of desperation, make sure you reach out to your care provider, because it really varies on doctor to doctor whether or not they support taking castor oil to induce labor. So make sure you go over it with them. But if they give you the green light to try it out, then what you're going to want to do is take a tablespoon of castor oil and wait 24 hours to see how it kind of affects your body. Make sure you are prepared to drink lots of fluids that might be displaced from any nausea that causes vomiting or any diarrhea that you might have, because that is a common effect of taking castor oil. So the ninth tip that I have for you that I recently learned about and wanted to share with you because I've heard it's really, really effective is midwife's brew. And this is a German labor cocktail and it's really commonly used by midwives in Europe. And so I'm going to share the recipe with you guys right now. So these are the ingredients that you're going to want to grab in order to make your German labor cocktail. You're going to want to have 10 ounces of apricot juice, 8 ounces of lemon verbena tea, 2 tablespoons of castor oil, and 2 tablespoons of almond butter. You're going to want to mix that all up, make sure it brews up really nicely, and then you're going to want to drink that on an empty stomach. Now this drink is not easy on the stomach, probably because of the castor oil that's in it. And so you just want to be careful when you're drinking it to, again, make sure you are replacing any fluids that you're losing from possibly vomiting from the nausea or having diarrhea from with lots of water so that you are staying nice and hydrated. If you're wanting to make this midwife's brew, definitely check in with your care provider first, but then I'll link all the ingredients and the recipe down below for you to check out. Now, last but not least, the 10th tip that I have for you is sex. So just like nipple stimulation, sex is going to help your pituitary gland to release that oxytocin, which I told you before is that labor hormone that is going to help your cervix get nice and soft and help those uterine contractions to begin. Now, sex is especially beneficial in helping kickstart labor naturally when mama is able to reach orgasm. And the reason for that is because an orgasm is basically like a mini feel-good contraction. And so basically, if that is triggering a contraction, it may trigger those uterine contractions that you want that is going to help enable labor to get started. So not only does sex help the body to release oxytocin and give that little contraction, aka that orgasm that mama experiences, but when a man ejaculates semen into a woman, that semen contains a ton of prostaglandins. And prostaglandins are what help ripen and prepare cervix to open, to dilate, to prepare for birth. Mama, baby is going to come out the same way that baby was put in there. So spending time with your partner, having sex with them is actually a good way to help induce labor and is also kind of a fun way to get labor on the road. So those are my 10 ways to help you naturally induce labor. If you have any questions about any of those things, about when to start them, about how to do them specifically, make sure you ask them in the comments below. I would love to get back to you on those answers. And thanks for watching this video. I hope it helps you. If you are at that 40, 41, 42 mark and you are desperate to have your baby in your arms finally, I hope that these 10 tips help you. Thanks for being here and I will see you in the next video. Bye, mamas.